Yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy Hazzy, and we're about to do a savage chest workout with my brother Hassan. You've seen him in the previous video before, him hitting 110 pounds on the incline dumbbells. Now what we're going to do is, it's a beautiful day in Montreal, the weather is beautiful, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna go inside at the gym to get a savage chest workout in. Now what you guys will learn is one major key that will enhance your workout tremendously. Now stay tuned, and I hope you guys get excited for the video that's about to come. This is an exercise just to warm up our shoulders. When we're gonna do the incline bench press, the flat bench press, we're gonna be using a lot of our shoulders. So it's very important that we warm up our rotator cuffs this way that we minimize the possibility of injury, but it also lubricates the area around the rotator cuff. This way, we can maximize our performance during the workout. So it's super important that you guys warm up before you do your proper exercises. It's always very important to warm up. Now, we're gonna warm up the back of our shoulders here. So I'm gonna bend with my hips down. Now, warming up is very important because it allows you to give time to your body to mentally prepare for the workout. It's extremely critical that you are 100% in it to perform at 100%. Whatever you do, whatever avenue that you go into, you always have to give 100%. So how do you do that? You prepare yourself for it. Do a warm-up. So that's what we're doing right now. Today, as we mentioned, we will start with the incline dumbbell press, since we want to focus on not only unilateral work but also bilateral work. Unilateral meaning one side, bilateral meaning both sides. So what I tend to do, major mistakes that people tend to make, is they always try to go heavy. What I like to do is I like to hit my muscle group 2 times a week. For most normal lifters, they try to hit it once a week. So the importance of maximizing growth in your chest or your shoulders is volume work. So most people tend to go for heavy sets, try to go for 3 reps. That doesn't tear up the muscles. That doesn't create enormous blood flow on the particular muscle you're trying to work on. I try to go for 60-70% my maximum rep. So for example, if I'm hitting 225 bench, I'll try to go for a working set of 12 times 135 pounds. This will allow maximal blood flow through my chest, and you will see my chest will be more volumized and it'll grow over time. So starting off with my first warm-up set, it's not really my working set. I'll start with 40 pounds. For some it may be heavy, but since I go fairly heavy all the way up to 100 pounds, these 40 pounds are my working set. So I'll try to go for 12 reps, make sure I squeeze my chest as I go down and as I go up, and maintain constant flow.
Constant tension, up one, squeeze, slow control.
sometimes. Sometimes I want to relive those nights again. I want to see it all again.
Alright guys, so as you saw, I was pushing 100s, my brother's pushing 90s. It doesn't matter how much you're pushing. At the end of the day, as long as you're pushing it to your limits, that's all that matters. We shouldn't be comparing each other. The only person we should be competing against is ourselves. As long as we're pushing at 100%, 200%, that's all that matters.
Alrighty, so this part got cut out, unfortunately, I don't know why, sorry mom. So, what I'm trying to explain in this video is that when you do the bench press, you want to squeeze your back so you can explode back up. It's essentially stretching your chest and putting your chest in the best position where you could squeeze those gains. And I apologize for that sweat stain on my armpits. Unfortunately, my deodorant did not work. But look at the excitement on my face, baby.
Alright guys, so we got at the end of the video right here. Now the major key that you guys want to know is that please do not compare yourself with other people. It's the tendency that every human being makes. This is why the gym is so intimidating, because we're always looking around at other people and seeing what they're doing, how they look. And let me tell you, that is very dangerous for you to do. That will push you away from not coming to the gym, you know? Always compare yourself with the previous you the day before. It's very important that you only compare yourself with you, because this is is the only way that you will grow. This is the only way that you will attempt new things and try them out and just progressively get better at them, you know? If you compare yourself and how you're going to look, maybe you're gonna put yourself in front of a camera and start talking, you know, and just seeing, you know, how much better could I get, you know, by just constantly keep doing it. It's the same thing when you come to the gym, you come for you. You come to train for you. Humble yourself. Use the weight that you're capable of using. Use proper form, because it will allow you to be in the right threshold and the right mindset for you to progress and for you to consistently show up. All right, if you've gotten this far in the video, thank you guys so much for watching the video. If you have any fitness related advice that you guys want to know, comment down below. Like the video if you like the video, subscribe if you haven't subscribed before, and share it with all your boys. I'll see you in the next one.